seen again. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Trimmer coming back at you with another video. Today is the day I'm going to New Zealand, guys. I've been waiting for this for about, I'd say, 2 months since I bought the tickets, and I'm really scared because of the planes. I absolutely hate planes. They just bug the living crap out of me. But yeah, today is the day I start my weekly adventure to New Zealand. I'll be traveling for about a whole day today, I think. I'm pretty sure. And then I'm gonna get into New Zealand around 6 o'clock in the morning. Probably have everything done at the airport and be leaving the airport over there like around 7. But right now, guys, if you're new around here, don't forget to subscribe and all that good stuff. I'm not really gonna talk about that because I'm more focused on the trip right now. But yeah, guys, right now I'm about to go have breakfast with my girlfriend, tell her bye before I leave. Let's go get some breakfast. Guys, this honestly does not seem real at all. Like, in my head, this is all fake, and I'm not going to New Zealand, but like, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna be on a plane for 13 hours, and it's just, it's crazy, you know? And right now, I'm gonna go pick up my girlfriend, go get some breakfast, because what kind of person doesn't eat before they go die, you know? All right, I just got done with breakfast, guys. I'm waiting for my brother so we can go leave to Amarillo, and when we get in Amarillo, we're probably gonna go eat it again. Look at Chirac! Chirac! You gonna miss me? You gonna miss me? Huh? You gonna miss me? Chirac. All right then. But yeah, we're gonna leave and probably go eat in Amarillo before I leave. And then after we eat, go straight to the airport, get everything checked out, checked in, we'll be golden. All right, guys, I just landed in Houston and about to get on the next plane to New Zealand. But it is so humid here and I'm sweating so bad. Got off the plane and it was just instant sweat. It was awful. But I'm about to go over there. There's a lot of people over there, so I didn't wanna touch. Okay. That's not me, but I didn't want everybody to see me vlogging. You know, everybody would have been staring. I didn't want them. People are still staring right now, but I'm about to go over there and board whenever they want me to, whenever they call me, I guess. But yeah, I got my water somewhere right here. I need to go to the restroom. That's what I'm gonna go do, guys. I know I missed everything after breakfast. I had breakfast, and I was in a rush to get over here. I swear I almost missed my plane to Houston. Beach water. But I swear I almost missed that plane to Houston, and I'm gonna go to New Zealand. So catch you on 12 hours, guys. 13 hours from here, from Texas time, but with all that time change, you know, it's only 1 over there in New Zealand right now. 7, it's 2 in New Zealand, and I'm arriving at 6 a.m., so you can tell how long this flight's gonna be. About a 12-hour flight. Let's get it. I'll hit y'all up when I'm in New Zealand. All right, guys, just landed in New Zealand. Going to get my bag really quick. I had to do some stuff with my passport. That's why I didn't film right when I got off the plane. But going to get my bags. Pretty sure I'm on the left, but I'm not sure which one I actually am. Is the Houston luggage on this side?
Houston? Yeah.
Okay, thank you. All right. So we do know where we're going now. I'm gonna get a luggage. I think I already found it, yeah. Pretty sure I just found my luggage. I'm gonna grab it really quick. We're about to go meet up with Jack's parents. After I get my luggage, probably gonna go. I don't know where to go after this, actually. I gotta go freaking. I gotta get out of the airport. That's my question. I don't know how to get out of this airport. Patiently wait for our luggage, you know. Gotta go change some dinero. Gotta go get some New Zealand money. Since they don't have the same currency as the United States. Well, I think that's my bag. Yep, there's my bag. Alright, so we got about another minute or so on here. And we're gonna grab that bag. This has to come all the way back in. The good question is, where do I go to get my currency change? I saw one, I think, earlier, but that was like right when I got off the plane, and I didn't have time for that because I came to get my luggage. So we are probably getting our bags, go meet up with Jack and his family, and then head to a currency exchange center because I got some money and I'm super hungry. That airline food, dude, it was amazing, I swear. We had breakfast, or we had dinner and then lunch, because we left so late from the US. But I honestly recommend it, guys. If you're gonna go travel, make sure to get a big plane. I was always scared of planes, like planes terrified me so bad. And like big plane, like you can't feel anything. I absolutely did not feel anything on that plane. Here comes my bag. Yep, here we go. Now we have to find out a way to get out of here. Way out. There it is. Way out. It says way out. So we're gonna walk over there. Jack's parents should be waiting for us. I know I've said that so many times, but they should be waiting for us. Kinda hungry, kinda not. I mean, we did just have, I got for dinner on the plane, I had what did I have? I had some chicken and marinara sauce. It was delicious. And then they gave us this cake with like this strawberry cream top. Like it was so delicious, I swear, dude. And then
such as shoes and sports equipment. Please dispose biosecurity risk items.
So guys, I know I missed a lot. I got to Jack's house, as you can tell. And everything's going good. I've been here for about 12 hours now, and everything's going great. This is, we got Baden, Pack, Alex, and Josh, and we got Six Mom over there. I love you. We just got done jumping at the trampoline park. Y'all can see that. That was probably, it's really insane. We don't have that. Back in Texas. Alex is leaving us. Yeah, I'll make you feel bad. You're leaving us. Baden's leaving us too.
I'm gonna miss you, Ben.
We are about to go to Jack's home and probably grab some food on the way. Hopefully.
Yeah.
No, we're not grabbing food on the way. So we're just gonna die of starvation.
So guys, after a very long day, we're finally back at Jack's house. I'm super tired. I think the jet lag is finally kicking in because it's 4:49, so back in Barryton it's 9:49 and it'd be nighttime and I'd be in bed crying. But now that we're at Jack's house, I can show y'all some of the stuff that his parents got me. This is called LMP. LMP is lemon and Pyroa. Lemon and Pyroa. Don't know what Pyroa is. They say they get it from like the dirt. From the town named Pyroa. They only sell this in New Zealand. His mom had a bunch of sweets for me waiting at my bed that they got. And I'm gonna do a video with these later. One day I probably just wanna do a vlog and I'll just do this video. And Jack told me that Dr. Peppers are really hard to find here, and that the first dairy we went to, I found a Dr. Pepper. So we're gonna open this and the LMP and see how they taste, because I want to see how the LMP tastes, and I want to see how New Zealand Dr. Pepper tastes. Hear that fizz? don't know if you can hear it actually. You think they'll be over here? It smells like lemonade. It looks like lemonade. It must be lemonade. Tastes like a very raw lemonade. Very brand new lemonade. That freshly squeezed. What's Paro? You said Paro?
Paro.
They get like the soil? And like the nutrients from the soil, like pixie dust on top of the lemon juice, I guess. They carbonate it. It says on the bottle, it says world famous in New Zealand or something like that. You can only get this in New Zealand, right?
Yeah.
Only in New Zealand. So. Sorry about your look. It's actually really good. Yeah. I thought y'all were hyping this up. If y'all want to see their money, they got some really. Yeah, I saw the point. I can't do a comparison because I don't have any coins. But here's one coin. Let's see if it'll focus. Here's one coin. And no, on the coin. There's a queen on the back. It has like, I don't even know what it has. It's like a statue or something. This is a 20 cent coin. Because they don't have quarters or anything. And then their money honestly looks exactly like Mexican money. If y'all have ever seen dollar bill pesos. Yeah. It looks exactly like they're like colorful. And they're like not paper, but they're like plastic material. I don't describe it. This is a $5 one. It has like a picture of New Zealand over here. And has a man, Sir Edmund Hillary.
First man to climb Mount Everest.
First man to climb Mount Everest. He's from New Zealand. He's a $10 one. You see it? Orange? Bright, bright orange. It's a bright, bright blue, a $10 one. Again, they have the New Zealand symbol over here, and this is Kate Shepherd on it. Okay, so apparently New Zealand was the first country to let women vote, and Kate Shepherd, who's on this $10 note, helped it by jumping in front of the horses in a horse race, but she died, obviously. Here's a $50 note. This one doesn't have a picture of New Zealand like the other one, but it has Sir Epreman Ngat. Jack doesn't know who he is, so. But yeah, this is a $50 note. This is the highest bill I have. I couldn't get my hands on a $100 bill. And they don't have ones, so. Yeah, these are the three notes I have. They're really colorful. Like the game of Monopoly. Great analogy. And the weird thing is about them. And the weird thing is about them that the smaller, like, the number, the smaller the bill. I mean, I guess that seems right. That's not how we do it in the U.S. Like, with this man. Like, it's 5'10 and 50. Like, it just, I find that so weird. They're different sizes. I haven't had a Dr. Pepper in about 3 days because of the flight and everything. And we're about to crack open this Dr. Pepper and see if it tastes like American Dr. Pepper. I'm pretty sure it does. You said it was imported from America?
No, probably.
It looks the exact same, so.
Damn. Is that good?
It's a lot sweeter.
I don't know the difference between any.
I don't know if that's just my head. That honestly tastes a lot sweeter than normal Dr. Pepper. It's probably my head though. Now I want to show y'all Jack's backyard. Jack's backyard is the most amazing thing on this earth. Like, this is not how American backyards are made. Alright. So one, you got over here, this is just like a shrubby, just grass and bushes, but look, he has a fence, it has rocks in it, and it has like grass on top. And it just keeps going up and up, and they have a trampoline, and just, and just gets filled with plants, okay? And it just keeps going, like this is actual soil right here. And they just have it planted everywhere. It's so pretty. This is day one of the New Zealand vlogs. It's been your boy Trimo, signing out. Peace.